In a world of tweets and text, email, and instant messaging.
That's cool. That's edited way too fast.
Are we communicating any better? Is it modern technology with the effects on both business and society?
There's a lot of spyware out there. Sneaks into your system, follows you wherever you may go.
Listen to Knowledge Doc. The show that said it all. With your host, Tariq Albarwani. Tuesdays at 5 p.m.
Emotion.
Global.
Face it and talk it through. A Knowledge Talk.
Knowledge Talk.
That's what'll get me to buy a smartphone.
Or a wearable computer.
Or a website that finally puts me in the driver's seat.
No.
Every week, here on the Nation Station Radio, Sultan of Oman, 90.4 FM.
Assalamu alaikum, good afternoon, and welcome to Knowledge Talks. A weekly edutainment and knowledge sharing program aired live specifically to share with you topics that contribute knowledge to the society. Every week, Knowledge Talks hosts and invites guests that are experts, professionals, and leaders from the field locally that bring wealth of knowledge to you. Knowledge Talks also highlights and promotes talents in the country that contribute knowledge and success to the nation. This program, ladies and gentlemen, is a weekly session that I will have with you every Tuesday at 5 p.m. I'm your host, Tariq Albarwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Sophia, for an hour bringing you free knowledge at your doorsteps on Oman Radio FM 90.4. Okay, stay tuned after this music break for today's interesting knowledge topic. Welcome back to Knowledge Talks, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tariq Albarwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Sophia, with you here live today on Oman Radio FM 90.4. From only having 2 riyals Omani in his pocket after graduating from school to running a successful IT business today. Hassan Ismail Muhammad Al Riyami has crossed all the challenges with simply having a big dream. Now that big dream is owning a successful business, traveling every year, and yes, driving a BMW. Hassan Al Riyami had always loved computers and electronics and has achieved, mashallah, all his success with a focus and hard work. Today he owns his own company, the Success Technology. I like that name, Success. Hassan today travels overseas at least twice a year, and when he's in Oman, he gets around in his BMW. These were part of his dream, mashallah. So what does it take to become successful today? Simply as Hassan says, believe and trust in yourself, work hard and start today. I'm very pleased to have Hassan with us today here at Knowledge Talks to share with us about his successful journey all the way from the start till today and his future plans as well. Hassan, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam, Tariq, and thank you for your bring me here to share my story. And I'm really glad so that I could share something that could inspire the world and inspire my brother and sister, and everyone could hear me today.
Inshallah. In fact, I'll tell you one thing. You have inspired me already. I remember where I've caught up with you a number of months ago in one of my friends' office. And then when I heard about you, when I saw the activity that you've done and when we spoke, mashallah, I fell in love already with all the things that you do. Mashallah, you have attained great success, Hassan, mashallah.
Thank you, Tariq. And you know, it's one of my dream has been coming true today, is to be here with you, as you was one of my inspired people. Since I was reading your article in the newspaper about the internet in 19th,
Alhamdulillah, those are good days. You know, Hassan, what I like about you and your story in specific is, mashallah, the passion that you have in computing and IT. And it relates a lot to what I have done. But mashallah, you've done in a bigger way, which is, that's why I love to have you here today, for me also to learn from you on how you were able to succeed in the things that you've done. Hassan, now I know about you, I've sat with you and I've learned of the thing that you've done, and we spoke over together about this. But today I want to take this opportunity for everyone else in Oman to know as well about the great things you've done. First, as a knowledge. Secondly, also for others, for us to create more success people in Oman. Could you please tell us about your journey?
Okay, I could start my journey, and excuse me that I will call my father as my teacher, because he is the inspired person in my life. Because of him, I became who I am now.
Ustaz Ismail.
Ismail.
MashaAllah, MashaAllah. I'm sure he's listening to the program today.
Inshallah, yes. Family, they are listening to
him. MashaAllah, your dad is definitely a great pride, MashaAllah, for you and the whole family. You have made a great for your family as well, MashaAllah.
And I'm really glad that to make my family also proud.
Alhamdulillah. You didn't make only your family proud, by the way. You made the whole Oman proud. So we are proud of you. Well done, Hassan. MashaAllah.
Okay, and I will call my father as my teacher.
Okay.
And the journey started that with my father. He was always involved me with his work, and even sometimes I don't like it and I don't want it, but he was wanted to force me just to come here and help me.
Okay.
And he was doing a lot of jobs at home, and from the story that started from there, to changing my concept later on when I start working with him.
Okay.
Like, he was doing electricity, fixing electricity at home and plumbing.
Okay.
And fixing dish antenna. Okay. And okay, that time when they are just came here in Oman.
When was it? What year was it? In the 80s, was it?
Yeah, in 19th.
In the
beginning
90s,
of 19,
okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And I remember that time I was in elementary school.
Okay.
Oh, and we was working together, and I see my father how he's doing his job by himself, and he not calling other people to help him in the electricity or plumbing or any jobs in the house.
MashaAllah.
So from that we got inspired. So my father is doing the job, so why not doing that? So I start, I start loving to be with him.
Okay.
Because I like to see how he's doing the work, then start, okay, asking questions.
MashaAllah.
What is this? Why this? Why that? And then I played a lot of the electricity and have made many of the shocks and
okay,
damage in the house, but yeah, that was learning.
Yeah. That's how we learn.
Yeah.
So he played a very big role in your life, your father.
Yes.
To where you are today.
Yeah. MashaAllah. And he is the one who teach me, by the way, he was being with me, that self-confidence and to be independent.
Okay.
And work smart and self-learning and help and support people. And he told me to never stop. When you have a problem, just try to find another solution. Just go on.
Okay.
Just do it. And I didn't felt it in that moment, but later when I left my home, in that, then I have remembering all my lessons with my father, and all my time with my father, because I've been alone since I moved from my home here.
Yes.
And I moved from Nizwa to Muscat.
Yes.
And in that time, it was my journey started here to looking for myself, as I didn't done well in my school.
Yes.
And my graduation wasn't helping me, so I was thinking, that's more than inspiring people, and people who change the world, they don't complete their school, so why I can do something, because I have the passion and I have the knowledge that I can do something, I can improve it. Mm. And in that time I was thinking, I go back again to that school, since I was passion for technology.
Yes.
And I was dreaming of the computer, and okay, that was my dream. And when I was going to ask my father, I want to buy this computer, he said, I don't have enough money for that. I said, okay, so why should always demand on my father to make one to buy, think what I, why I'm doing it with myself.
Well done.
And then I think, okay, computers needs money.
Yeah.
So where I can get money. So first of my thoughts came because my father, they were giving me 200 pesos every day to go to the school.
Yes.
So from that, I get bring that idea, start saving that every day, 200, 200, 200 for, and also I ask my brothers to help me if they want to join me with, to buy a computer. Then they be cooperating with me.
Wow.
So I was collecting the money all together, my brothers, to just to achieving that. So you want a computer.
Mashallah.
And even they don't know about the computer, but just because they believing on me. So just they're starting supporting me.
Mashallah, mashallah.
After 3 years, I remember that it was in class 7, and I got it when I was in the first secondary.
Okay.
And when I got to my first computer, I go to my father, I told him, I want a computer. He said, I don't have enough money for that. He said, okay, let's go. I have the money.
Okay, that was awesome.
Yeah. And he was shocked. So where did you get the money? I said, I saved them all that 3 years from the Eid, from everybody giving me money and doing some other jobs and like to have that money.
Yeah.
Until I got that money, it was really, it's my, when you see that computer front of me, it was really heavy. And in that time, really, I don't know how to use it. I don't know how to fix it.
What
I don't
computer was it, if you don't mind me asking?
It's called assembled computers.
It was an assembled?
Yeah.
What processor was it?
It was 166. 166, yeah.
Wow! 166 megahertz, you mean?
Yeah,
okay,
and it's about 64 RAM.
Okay.
And 32 RAM.
Okay.
Yeah, and it was having...
DOS?
DOS.
Was it DOS or Windows?
Windows 98.
Windows 98, okay, okay. Yeah. During the Windows 98, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, amazing.
And there's a story about Windows. When I started Windows 98, they... the computer engineer, he installed Windows 98 in Arabic.
Okay.
And I had it only for him. He said, this language, I can't learn it in Arabic. I have to learn it in English. And even I wasn't good in English. But I forced myself because I want to learn English.
MashaAllah, mashaAllah.
Then the next, a week later, I go back again there and I told him I want it in English.
Yeah.
And then he changed it to me in English and he bring it to me. And at that time, he gave me 1 year warranty.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, because I was learning, I break it many times.
Mm.
So I said, okay, now is 1 year.
Yeah.
I fix it for free.
Yeah.
So what
was
about
warranty,
after warranty is over? So I have to pay 5 years every time. I said, no, I need to learn how to fix it.
Awesome.
Then from that time that I was, every time, every week, I learn new things.
Yeah.
I damage it and I just take it to the workshop.
Yeah.
And I was sitting there.
To see what they do.
Look how they fix it.
Mashallah.
And they didn't want to share with me something there, but I was just sitting with them.
And observing them.
Yeah, and check, okay, they need floppy disk, the CD, and what that CD, then I start searching from where I can get this.
Mashallah.
Until I found the DOS. Mm. Then I format, but they don't have the Windows.
Yeah.
So I stuck without no operator system, but I know how to format it.
Yeah.
Okay, then I bring it back to him again.
Yeah.
And then he load the Windows. Then I find, there is a Windows.
Yeah.
Anyway, I started to learn how to fix it and even how to assemble it and take the parts, install
without it. Without attending any course, any class or anything?
No.
MashaAllah.
And
this all goes back to passion. Do you agree on that?
Yeah.
If you're passionate and you have interest in something, you would do anything to learn it about it. And in fact, there are people who go and take classes and courses might not be able to do it better than you because you have interest. If they don't have an interest, that's it.
I will come later about the story about the courses.
Okay,
I have
attended
some courses, but I didn't complete them.
Okay.
I will tell you the stories
later.
Looking forward. After maybe a year, within that year, I learned how to fix the computer, how to assemble it. And then I said, oh, okay, that I can earning some money because he earning 5 reals in each computer. So I can even ask some people if they want to fix it, that I can earn some money. Because I'm looking for my independent income. I don't want to demand with my father. And also I want to help my father.
I respect that fully.
And I think that I need to help myself.
Yes.
Because instead he's spending money on me, I could help him to I be independent, spend my money with myself. And because also I have a passion to buy and everything with the technologies.
Yes.
And electronics, cameras, TV. And
So you had a passion that was very good, which is computing. You also saved your own money in order to buy a computer. And you told me as well that you didn't do well in school, but you had in your mind a passion that you wanted to start your own business. And in that, can we agree that whatever people take from school is the things that they will apply at their workplace? So you go to school to learn about things that you will do at your workplace, but they don't teach you about entrepreneurship, how to become a businessman.
Yeah.
Can you agree with that?
Yes.
And that's what happens to you.
Yeah.
So you went to school, you didn't get good grade, but you went out, you did your business, and today you are a successful person. And your the name of the business is Success Technology as well. Yes. MashaAllah, alhamdulillah. Ladies and gentlemen, that's one a very good point to know, ladies and gentlemen. You go to school, very good. And you end up in school, you go to work for a company. That's what you're expected to do. But it doesn't necessarily mean if you don't do good grades, you can't start your own business. I'm not saying that even if you go to school, you can't start your own business. But it also means if you have an interest and you work very hard, you can do very well. There's a lot of examples in this world from Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, and so on, who have dropped out and have done great in their life. But we don't need to go very, very far. We have Hassan in Oman, and Hassan has done great for himself. But what I'm trying to say is work very hard in the school, but for the ones who have finished school, don't say that ma fi shughal wasta. No, you go out there, work hard, and ensure you do very well. And here an example we have with Hassan. And for parents, ladies and gentlemen, parents, you need to work very, very close with your kids. Because if you work very, very close with your kids, you give them the necessary skills and confidence for them to do very well. Here's a very, very example of Hassan. He is very, very close to his father, Ismail, which I'm sure he's listening. And congratulations, Ustaz Ismail. MashaAllah, you have created a great man here for Oman, who is already doing around, MashaAllah. So that's an input that we need to share. And of course, you need to work hard and learn, as Hassan has put it in.
Yeah.
And another important thing, ladies and gentlemen, you need to save your money. Hassan bought his own computer. And how did he do it? Is because he was saving money. He was getting 200 bases every day, saving the money, and bought a computer. He didn't go buy the chips and Mino and go out. You know, he went there and he made sure he put the money and bought some things. Hassan, go ahead.
After finishing that school and I didn't find a good job, the good grade, I was thinking to go come to Muscat and looking for a job. And in that time, I remember I have only 2 years. When my father, he told me, just go to the military. I said, this is not my field.
Yeah, you like technology.
Yeah, because I like technologies. And so I just follow my dream and follow my passion. That's where is it taking me. And then it's okay. And then I came here to Muscat. And I was, I remember in that time, I asked my cousin to take me to the market to looking for a job there.
So you came from Nizwa all the way to Urkhov or Sib?
To Sib.
Sib, okay.
Yeah.
And you're looking for a job. You just had two riyals in your pocket.
2 riyals. Mm-hmm. And that's 2 riyals I spent. But my cousin, he was have a car, but he didn't have a petrol in the car. I said, okay, give me this 1 riyal and just go. We'll go to find a place.
For a job?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then I found going in the Sib markets, shop by shop.
Okay.
All that day just looking, asking for a job, any
okay.
job.
Okay.
I just want a job.
Okay.
And then I wasn't succeed. Then the next day I asked him again, he said, I don't have the bet. I said, okay, take buy the last 1 riyal and let's go to Al Khud. And he said, today I will not go back until I find a job. Then I went to the shop Al Khud and I was starting the shop by shop until the last shop that I've been there. Then I was there as a internet cafe.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy is asking me that, what is your interest and what is your hobbies and what you can do. I said, I can fix computers and I can good in computers. And he was testing me, said, okay, you can come and work tomorrow and I will see you how it's gonna work. I was really happy.
MashaAllah. Did you have to show him any certificate?
No.
Did you have to show him any papers, anything that showed that what is your capability?
No.
You just had to show them that you're confident, right?
Yes.
MashaAllah. Well done.
And the next day I start working there. He told me at 8 o'clock. I start working at 8 o'clock. And
and what time did you arrive there?
At 8.
Okay, at 8 sharp you arrived.
Yeah, it was 8. I was always going before because my cousin, he was leaving early. So
okay.
I have to go there early.
And
so always sometimes before 8 I will be there.
So you arrived at the work before the working hours.
Yeah, I'm just waiting
awesome.
For him to come to open the shop and then I start my day there. And
well
when
done.
I start working, I just not leaving because I don't have a car to go back home.
Awesome.
So I just closing and just finish fix in the break time between 1 to 4. I was fixing the computer because at the evening they will have people who's coming to use the internet.
Okay.
And from that time, this shop, it was only for the internet cafe.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't fixed the computer, but one became the idea because I want to kill my time there because doing nothing.
Yeah.
And then I started asking people if they have a computer need to be fixed. Then there is one guy, he bring a computer and he fix it. And even the owner said, do you can fix the computer? I said, I will try.
Mm-hmm.
I am not having that much experience, but I want to try. I want to do this.
Yeah.
And then, alhamdulillah, we've been succeed because, there is challenging. Sometimes it takes for me time, but because there is the internet, that have my passion. Always asking the internet.
Google.com.
Yes.
In awesome.
That time, there is no Google.
Awesome.
I think that time is Yahoo.
It was Yahoo, and it was AskGVS.com, and MSN.
Yeah,
Alta Vista.
Yes.
Those good days, huh?
Yeah.
Mashallah. But what I like about you, Hassan, is that you use the internet. Internet is the wealth of information there, so you can get anything you want.
Yeah.
And then you also worked very hard to get the information done.
Really agree about that. And it is like tools like you can utilities to get the benefit that you want. You can just one click, you get
and get everything. And today, there's the ways of getting information is even easier. You can use mobile phones to get information. Using those days, you and I, it was you have to go to the computers, connect to the internet, and use the modem and use the sound. You know,
yeah.
But now things are connected 24 hours, isn't it? Mashallah.
Yes, I agree. I was remembering how the days, how it's taking time to download and to connect to the internet. It was trying sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes busy. Yeah, but now it's 24 hours with the broadband connectivity. And yeah. Mashallah.
And there is a huge difference with the internet. And I was really passionate about the internet. I remember I subscribed for the internet in 97.
Okay. That's when GTO introduced the internet. Yes.
Yeah, and then from that time that I was, my dreams came that I want to work for this company, GTO.
I
get the internet, because they have the technologies. I don't have the money to buy all of things, but if you be in the environment, you can learn and you can use it.
Mashallah. And did you work for them?
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. Mashallah. So you also had, I see your life is a chain of dreams, but not only dreams of I wish, it was I will and I'll do it. And you achieved them, mashallah.
Yeah.
So you work for GTO as well?
Yeah, I work for GTO at that time, but now it's Omantel.
Now it's called Omantel, yes.
For 13 years.
For 13 years you worked for Omantel.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay.
And I started with the call center agents.
Okay.
And later I moved to network operations center.
Wow.
And I worked there for 5 years.
Okay.
7 years there I've been in that section working with the lease line, MBLS, ADSL.
You've been exposed to a lot of internet technologies.
Yeah.
Okay.
And in 2013 I thought about that I want to make my dream to be independent, to be myself employee and to make my own business.
Entrepreneur.
Yeah. So I decided to resign on 2013.
Okay.
I remember it in June. And it was not easy decision.
Yeah.
To take it, because you are leaving your secure income and you don't know you're going to fulfill, you don't know how it is. But I was having something inside of me that telling me just, Hassan, go on and Allah will bless you and will open doors for you.
Inshallah.
And that's, I was thinking to resign two, three years before that. I was told them, this year. I said, no. And when I go even to ask some friends, I want to leave the job and I want to get, they said, no, it's better for you to stay in that job and it's secure.
Yeah.
Then I was listening to them, but there's something always inside of me. Mm. Hassan, go on. Just to get
there's
out
something
from
out there is waiting for me.
Yeah, because I felt myself I can do more.
Yeah.
In that I'm doing very well in Oman. I really love that environment. Yeah. I love it so much. And I was doing most of the time there. And the work there, it was really fun.
Okay.
And I really appreciate with my colleagues and all my managers, and I'm really having very good time with them. But I feel myself that I can, maybe I'm not good if I leave that job. I can give this my seat to someone else who can also get, and I can go for my own and can achieving even more of my dreams.
Okay, awesome.
And I started that in 2013, that I'd be full time. Before I was only part time, doing only.
So you're doing, while you're working for Omantel, you had your own business as well.
Yeah, I was doing it after the work.
I'm really enjoying what you're saying, Hassan. We'll just take a quick break and return back to discuss about your exciting, successful journey.
Oman FM on 90.4, 91.3. In a world of tweets and text, email, and instant messaging, are we communicating any better? Is it modern technology with the effects on both business and society?
There's a lot of spyware out there. Sneaks into your system, follows you wherever you may go.
Listen to Knowledge Talk, the show that said it all, with your host, Tariq Al-Barwani, Tuesdays at 5 p.m.
Emotion.
Global.
Face it and talk it through. A Knowledge Talk.
Knowledge Talk.
That's what'll get me to buy a smartphone.
Or a wearable computer.
Or a website that finally puts me in the driver's seat.
No.
Every week, here on the Nation Station Radio, Sultan of Oman, 90.4 FM.
Welcome back to Knowledge Talks, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Sophia, with you here live today on Oman Radio FM 90.4. Interesting discussion with Hassan Ismail Muhammad Al Riyami, who has started his life with only $2. I mean, when I say started his life, it's basically after graduating from school, with only $2 in his pocket. And today he is running a successful IT business. Hassan Al Riyami, has crossed all the challenges with simply having a big dream. He wanted to have a business, a good one. He wanted to travel every year. He's traveling every year and drive a BMW. Hassan, tell me one thing. Did you come with a BMW today?
Yes.
So you're going to take me for a ride?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Please don't miss me for that. Now, how many places have you traveled?
About 15 countries.
Wow, mashallah. What other countries have you gone to?
Shall I list them?
Wow, man.
I've been in Europe and Asia.
Okay.
And Gulf.
Okay.
All the countries. And my planning for the next year to go to America and Canada.
I love that. Awesome, man. There's a lot of interesting things to see as well. There's a lot of learning one gets from traveling. So every year you travel twice?
Yeah, twice, but I'm planning that to travel every year for 5 countries.
MashaAllah. I respect. So you travel 5 countries in a year?
Yeah.
And you travel twice, so you go to 5 countries?
Yeah.
And do you go alone?
Sometime alone, sometime with my brothers.
MashaAllah. You take all and you pay for all of them?
Not all.
Okay, but awesome. I mean, the traveling and taking them, that's more than enough. I mean, I respect that fully. Where is your next destination? So it's America.
America and Canada.
America and Canada. Yeah. Any specific place in America?
New York, San Francisco, New York City. California.
My man, and if you go to San Francisco, please make sure you go to the Silicon Valley. Silicon Valley is the place where all the IT geniuses and all the IT gurus, in fact, Facebook has got their station there, Google has got their station over there. And you know what? If you go there, you please come back, because when you go there, they might not even let you allow to come back. So will you come back or will you stay there?
I will come back, inshallah, but that's the advice is that always... So what my friend saying to me that we are afraid that if you go to US, that you will not come back.
I tell you that. I can see it, man. I can see it. I can see it. If you go, you won't come back. But we need you here in Oman. We need people like you to enrich us with technology. For inshallah, it's good to go. There's a lot of interesting things. With the largest computer museum history. You will love it. Believe me. But if you go, you have to come back. Now tell us about the business. You left GTO, which is today called Omantel. And you started your own business. Is it the Success Technology?
Yes.
Awesome. And why do you call it Success Technology?
Success Technology?
Yes. Why do you call it Success Technology?
Because we are the success. It is something is motivating me that reaching the technology is reaching to success. It's something like the way.
The way to reach success. It's very positive name, by the way. It's about success. And all the people that you work with, you provide them success. I love that. So what do you do in your business?
We are doing installing the Wi-Fi solutions and networking and also CCTV camera and IP camera, telephone system, access control and music system. So we are providing the full complete solutions for the enterprises and individual for their places. And how we are working that we are providing solutions. How these solutions are we... When we're getting the request from the client, so we are moving our team to the client and we diagnostic the places and you check and survey what it needs and we make the proper solution to them and then brought about the solutions.
Awesome.
Yeah. So and
I'm sorry, you do it for people, home users, business users?
Yeah, both.
You do for both?
Yeah.
Awesome. How many clients have you served so far?
Oh, so many. I can count them. More than hundreds.
MashaAllah. More than 100 customers already.
Yeah.
You said both home users and business users.
Yeah. But
how can people contact you?
They contact me through my website and also they are contacting by word of mouth.
Okay.
So I done great jobs to you. So you are referring to the other your friends and the other friends. So I'm always getting inquiries through this way.
And I think word of mouth is one of the most powerful modes of advertising.
Yeah, and that is what we are always aimed at. You are getting customer satisfactions because that's our aim. Because if you have done a good jobs and be able to keep continuous with and also to maintain and supporting them.
Okay. How many hours do you work in a day?
I don't count the hours because I love what I'm doing.
I love that. That's a very powerful word, ladies and gentlemen.
So I'm not calling I'm working, I'm playing.
Love what you do, ladies and gentlemen, to the limit of playing and you become successful. Okay?
And there is also, they can contact us in our contact numbers. Mm-hmm. 9673366 0.
Okay.
I will repeat it again. 9673366 0.
Okay.
Or they can log into our website and they can submit the work order request there, and it will reach to us, and then we will contact them immediately and we'll sign the appointment with them. The thing is that the people or our client, we don't want them to leave their site or their places. We will come to them.
Mm-hmm.
And just relax there at your home or your enterprise's company, and we will come there and we will serve you. And whatever we think that you needed there, we will come there and we'll figure it out for you.
Awesome. I really, really like it. Now, tell me one thing. Most of people who want to start business, well, there's a lot of people who want to start a business. They need money. They need to have some capital. How did you go about money? Did you take a loan from a bank, or did you approach, you know, that the government is supporting now, we've got this initiative like the Ruffet and so on. How do you go about getting money to run your business?
I don't believe of a bank loan.
Mm-hmm.
And also I didn't take any money from the government. They got to supporting, but how we started that. Sometimes I started with a friend.
Okay.
He helped me to start the business, and then later I start to reinvesting the money that we are having.
Okay.
So the main reasons of reinvesting the money, I start to saving and reinvesting them in the business. I was starting to make more money, and then it will make you, the cash flow is coming to you, and depends on the service. Like I started with the service.
Okay.
Not to purchase, because I understand that the capital needs money to be with you. But
true.
When starting service, it's not, it's only costing you the time
and
your knowledge.
True.
So I save that money to bring the company up.
Mashallah. And how many people do you have in your team?
Now we have three.
Okay.
We have three working.
Three full-time employees working under you.
Yeah. Okay. And planning to increase that by the next year.
Okay. Inshallah.
Because we are getting some more inquiries.
Okay.
So we're trying to, because we want to serve our clients faster.
Yeah.
Because, you know, a lot of people now, mostly of our clients, they're having problems with the internet.
Okay.
And they want also the Wi-Fi, and that's, you know, their needs for that. So they need more, fast support for them.
Okay, awesome. And what about the challenges? Did you face any challenges? Or are you facing any challenges running your business?
Yes, there is always challenging. And this challenging is like, you need to learn from that. Like one of the challenges that we had it, if I remember the time.
Okay.
That's the most simple, because we don't have sometimes having the time to serve many multiple clients,
mm-hmm.
and you're getting some inquiries there, and also to deliver it at the same at the time we have scheduled it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the challenging, but that we try to, now we, as we have the experience, because at the beginning we have that issue, so now we mostly it's not there, so because we make the appointment with them, so we know that how much time is we need for that client, so
mm-hmm.
we just make them end the time scheduled.
Okay.
So that we solved it. And,
okay. Any other issues? What about customers? Customers, being painful, or you think, no, they're just okay, they're good? Being tough sometime. You know, there are other people who complain that customers are tough. I know people, generally, as it's known, people say a customer is the king. But I don't necessarily agree that the customer is a king. You can be a king too. You decide who you want to service and provide services. So, in your opinion, is the customers a pain?
Yeah.
They are a pain sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay.
But, it is there. Sometimes we are getting that tough client or something, but we understand why they are, because they are facing problems.
Okay.
When I'm going to solve, I don't focus on the client, how he has behavior, or whatever, because he has a problem. I focus on solving the problem.
Yes.
After solving the problem, he will be happy.
Yes.
And most of them, they should just not focusing in how the people they are, because there is a reason because of that. Check about solving the reasons.
Yes.
Then the customer will be happy, and they'll be always remembering you.
Yes, yes. No, I respect that fully. Now, you are an IT person. You are very smart, mashallah. You have done very, very well. with your life, mashallah, and I wish you a great success, inshallah, for the future. Talking about the business, you own your business and you're doing well as well. What I need to know is business knowledge necessary to run a business?
Yes, I advise people when they want to start business, they should know about that field. You're not just going to the business and they're running that business and they don't know how it is running and how it's going to work. Mm-hmm. And the thing that would make them also be succeed that they love what they do. They just not do it because I found there's and people, they are doing the business because they want money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. The money, but if they're looking for the success and the money will always follow them.
True.
Because they're all having the passion, they have to be patient to earning, and they have to get also customer satisfaction.
Mm-hmm.
The thing is, it become to them later. The money it will come as the fun you're doing well job, the money it will come to you. But just only focusing about the money, sometimes they were not running for so long. And there is an advice also, they have to be up to date, because now that life and the technology is improving and developing every month, everything is there, there's new things to come in the field. And that's one of the reasons that I always visiting the exhibitions like Jitex or Comex to see what is new, what's the latest technology. I always updating and checking for the internet what's the latest technology solutions. And that would help me also how to help the clients to get their exactly what their needs.
Okay, awesome. So very nice input, ladies and gentlemen, and tips and advice from someone who's running his own business right now, Hassan. And that is, number one, you need to have a passion on the business that you do. You need to know the business very well and just not do any business. Don't go for the money. Let the money follow you. That's what he advised. And also, last but not least, he says, stay updated, keep up to date. By doing that, you will be ahead of the game. MashaAllah. Let us, ladies and gentlemen, take a quick break and we'll return back with Hassan's exciting and successful journey.
Number one, Radio Sultanate of Oman.
Exciting interview today with Hassan Al Riyami, the owner of Success Technology, and we have spoken about how he has started his business from simply $2, and today he has achieved and completed his dreams. And he's doing very, very well, mashallah. Ladies and gentlemen, we're taking a call on 2460-2058. I will repeat. The number is 2460-2058. Hassan, what I need to know is I would like to start a business. However, I don't have money. I don't have money at all. And a number of people today say that, I want to start a business, but I don't have money. Well, one of the approaches is to go to Rafid, and that's a government initiative to support entrepreneurs for Oman. And the other one is to go to a bank loan. What is your advice on how, I'm not talking about the money part, but how can someone start a business if he, she doesn't have that kind of support?
My advice, they can start using their experience or knowledge that to create a service. You can sell the service. From that service, they can earn money. And from that money, they can creating their own business. And so it is starting with zero loan, which that make them more freedom. In case when going for the loan, it's become more stressful later if they couldn't pay that loan.
Okay.
So you starting with the selling services, you can find yourself what you are capable to do and just selling self, or you can cooperate with the other who are doing the business, just help them. Mm-hmm. Me cooperating with the other organization or something doing that business, and they just cooperate with them and you can help them also. Okay. To create, and also that will help you to create your base of clients,
mashallah.
And that, and also there you need to make the market study.
Okay.
And that's will help you to understand what the market's needs. And make short-term goals to reach your final goals.
Okay.
Because sometimes people, they make big dreams and they say, oh, I can't do it because that's cost so much and it's taking a long time.
Okay.
But you just, when you break it and then you can reach it to it, and we are making a small term and you are achieving with a small period, and you can achieve that to give you even motivation to do continuous moving.
Okay. Okay. We have a caller. Let's just pick a call on air. Hello. Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
It's Mohammed Al-Rahdi. Sorry, it's not clear. I cannot hear you.
Okay, hello?
Yes, hello?
Yes, hi, sir.
Okay, is this... am I speaking to Tariq?
Yes, this is Tariq.
That's Mohammed Al-Rahdi.
Hi, how are you doing, sir?
Yeah, I'm fine. And you? You're right.
I'm doing very well, sir.
Okay, just, can I talk now?
Yes, please go ahead.
Sorry, it's not clear. I'm just listening to Hassan Al Riyami. I just want to say, my name is Mohammed Rahdi, Managing Director of Expat TV Arabia. Hassan done some really great, amazing work for my company. And I'm listening to Hassan on the radio. He's a really hard-working bloke. And I enjoyed his work and all the work he's done for my company. I wish for Hassan all the best, all the success in what he's doing. Looking forward to see his company to be one of the number one leading companies in IT in Oman.
Inshallah, inshallah. He is going to Silicon Valley. The next thing you're going to see that he's going to have success technology of Omani-based company in Silicon Valley in San Francisco. He's going to America. And guess what? He's going to also, inshallah ta'ala, sign up for an IPO. Would you be buying some shares, Mr. Mohammed?
Sorry?
Will you be buying some shares, some stocks from the company? It's your opportunity to become a billionaire, my friend.
Definitely. And maybe because I'm one of his clients, and I'm expecting to get a bit of special price.
Okay, inshallah. Hassan, you know that Mr. Mohammed.
Thank you, Mr. Mohammed. And you sure that you are getting the best price? As you are my... my best friend, we are cooperating together. I'm really thank you for your cooperation with us.
Expat TV Arabia wouldn't be successful without your support. Thank you very much, Hassan. I wish you all the best.
Yeah, welcome. Welcome anytime, my brother.
That's awesome. That's a very good remark, a very good feedback from one of your customers on your business. And that says very, very big, Hassan. You know, one thing, if customers are very, very happy, that itself is self-explanatory. So I wish you the very best, inshallah. Hassan, we have just a few minutes to end up the program. What is your future plans and goals, inshallah?
My future plan that we would like to be number one in the service field in our IT in Oman and also in global.
Inshallah.
And inshallah, we are looking forward to opening automotive smart home solutions.
Okay, inshallah. Are you taking staff right now? Can people apply for jobs in your company?
Not currently, but that will be by the next year.
Okay, and how do you take it through, via email or something?
Yeah, by the email.
We can send you CVs if we want to join you.
Yes.
I can send, I'll send you my CV. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we've come for the end of our session today. Hassan has done a very, very great activity, and mashallah, he's done a great name for himself. We've received a call from the bloke, Mohammed Rahbi, who spoke so very, very nice about it. We've come to the end of our program. I hope you all had a terrific time with us. Let us catch up again next week on Tuesday, same time, 5 p.m. for a knowledge session. I'm Tariq Hilal Al-Barwani, along with our studio engineer, DJ Sophia, wishing you all a happy and a pleasant week. Ma'a salama.
About it.